We saw much more than students here, really a mix of ages that we saw. And it's 110 degrees out here, so it does feel like a slightly more low-key Trump rally, just a handful of vendors and not the carnival atmosphere that I'm used to seeing at a Trump rally. Earlier today, the president was near Yuma, Arizona. He had a roundtable with border officials, and the White House had touted that visit as a way for Trump to talk about the 200 miles of border wall that had been built. In fact, since Trump took office, only 3 miles of new barrier has been erected. Judy?
So, Stephanie, you told us that you've talked to some of the people who waited for hours in line to get in to see the president in this 110-degree heat. What precautions are being taken around health and around the COVID virus?
Yeah, there were people that were waiting for hours in this heat, Judy, to get in to the church. That also means that they've been sitting inside that church with it circulating air for hours as they're waiting for the president to take the stage. Some people were wearing masks. I would say about 20% were wearing masks in this heat. A lot of people said they would put masks on once they got inside the venue. Some people said they would not put masks on unless they were forced to do so. And a few people really said they were making a political statement by not wearing a mask.
I think the whole COVID thing is kind of like a slippery slope. The left, the government in general, they're trying to see what they can get away with. They see how many people are going to be sheep and wear the masks. And they're going to see, okay, if we can get away with that, what other rights can we infringe upon?
Now, the Phoenix City Council, Judy, did pass an ordinance just a few days ago requiring people to wear masks in public places. But the Phoenix mayor said she is not planning to enforce that and hand out citations and $250 fines among the people at the rally, and of course not with the president either. I will say that a local reporter inside that I've been talking to says there is absolutely no social distancing in there, and there is a minimal amount of mask wearing. Obviously, this mass gathering goes against CDC guidelines. The mayor's statement today also said there really is no safe way to hold a rally like this in this pandemic.
And Stephanie, one other thing. We know